you say it, Wamego or Wamego, it's a town worthy of a zip trip.
Wamego is just a great place. It really is. It's some place a lot of folks like me, young families, choose to raise their kids here. Proximity to Topeka and proximity to Manhattan makes it very attractive for somebody that's looking for a little bit smaller town to live in. But we like to say that we punch above our weight.
Founded back in 1866 as a support community for the Kansas Pacific Railroad, Wamego, Kansas never took off as a bustling town. But folks here don't seem to mind. With a population of just more than 4,800 people, it's a town that offers residents and visitors a walk through history and a little fantasy. Just about an hour and a half from Kansas City and just north of I-70, you'll follow the Road to Oz Highway, also known as 99 Highway, right into charming downtown, featuring hometown eateries, quaint little shops, and Wamego City Park. Spend an afternoon taking a step back in history as you learn about the Kanza and Potawatomi Native Americans, the original inhabitants of the area. Learn how the Underground Railroad played a role in the area. Even take a hike along the Oregon Trail and explore where wagon ruts can still be seen hundreds of years later.
A ton of great history here. It's something, especially with our close connection to Fort Riley, that we actually get a lot of people out interested in history.
If it's fantasy you came for, take a walk through downtown Wamego, Kansas, and you'd think you landed in the land of Oz. The home of the Oz Museum, the Oz Winery, and Toto's Tacos, everyone around has caught on to Oz fever. Don't forget to find and follow all the Totos.
It's the Wizard of Oz, it's just fun.
When you get a little hungry, their hometown eateries have been ranked as some of the best. There is a cafe or restaurant for everyone. Keep exploring and you'll find that Wamego is more than just a small dot on the map.
Experience. We're all about experience. It's just that Americana flair of a thriving small town, and we'd like people to enjoy that. Wamego is just a great place. It really is. It's some place a lot of folks like me, young families, choose to raise their kids here. Proximity to Topeka and proximity to Manhattan makes it very attractive for somebody that's looking for a little bit smaller town to live in.
And it's a town for folks looking for adventure and history, something Wamego has plenty of. It starts with the town's historical museum and Prairie Village. On it are buildings straight out of the 1800s, as well as a place to learn about those that took part in the Underground Railroad, the evolution of several Indian tribes, and see the famed Dutch mill.
There's plenty to see while walking through town. In fact, if you're in the mood for a little adventure, you can go on a bit of a hunt. Hunting for Toto, there's 15 in all, and you gotta find them all before you leave town.
There's multiple Oz-related businesses. We've got our Totos around town, which are a great photo opportunity. 15 of them, you can go find them all over the community, done by Kansas artists.
Which leads us to our next stop, the Yellow Brick Road. Located near the middle of the square, the Yellow Brick Road leads you to a quaint bakery and on a continued adventure.
And as you complete your journey down the Yellow Brick Road, you'll find not only another Toto, but also your destination, the Oz Museum, home to thousands of visitors every year to the town.
About 35,000 people a year come just for the Oz Museum. I think the town has come to appreciate the added traffic through and want to give everyone that wonderful Wizard of Oz experience down to the Yellow Brick Road, Emerald City, and all through the town.
It feels like Kansas, what it's supposed to feel like when you go to the Wizard of Oz. Well, the house by McDonald's was really unique. We just thought that was a nice little touch before you actually come to the museum.
So like Dorothy's house, why not drop in to Wamego? Marcus Officer, Fox 4 News.